Now, there'll be more detailed instructions in terms of how this is going to work, in terms of the discussions, but right now I'd really like to move directly into our first substantive presentation and introduce my close friend, Arnie Kaluzny. Arnie Kaluzny has served as chairman of our Multilevel Interventions Steering Committee over the past year and a half, and he's really been very involved in contributing his expertise and insight on the structure and function of healthcare organizations. Dr. Kaluzny is Emeritus Professor of Health Policy and Management at the UNC Gillings School of Public Health, and also a Senior Research Fellow at the Cecil Shepp Center for Health Services Research at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. He's a prolific author of books and book chapters and journal articles, and he's a leader in the field of health organization and management, and also cancer control and prevention. He is a recipient of numerous awards and served on numerous advisory committees here at NCI. Dr. Kaluzny, do you want to start us off?
Very good. Thank you very much, Steve, for your very gracious words, and let me welcome you to our meeting today, next 2 days. What I'd like to do is take about 10 minutes, sort of put this into context and provide some overview of how we're going to be dealing with some of the issues that Steve had mentioned. Let me see if this works. There we go. One of the things that I think we do very well in health services is develop interventions. And what we have here is sort of an array of interventions over the years, ranging for various activities within cancer prevention and control, such as the CCOPs, such as the ASSIST program, the COMMIT program, the NCCP, which we're currently involved in, as well as last 10 years, a tremendous focus on total quality management, CQI, DRGs, probably the new flavor of the month that's getting a lot of attention is the electronic medical record and guidelines and checklists. And all these activities are usually presented with a great deal of passion because we're dealing with very, very important kinds of activities, focusing on the issues of quality, safety within health services, the issues of cost containment. That's what DRGs was all about, continuous quality improvement, quality and cost, as well as the bottom line being health. The issue really is to step back, and I think probably the premise of this meeting is how well are we doing with respect to these kinds of things? Are these things really meeting our expectations? And in terms of quality and safety, despite efforts, we're now 10 years past the legendary, very important study the Institute of Medicine had on the quality Chisholm. This really remains in doubt. One of the things that struck me very recently was an article in the New England Journal of Medicine, which focused on 10 hospitals in North Carolina. I don't know whether you've read that article, but I really suggest that you take a look at it because I've cited it here, in which they selected 10 hospitals that had really committed to the IHI's Quality Improvement Safety Initiative. And then they went back and did a very, very detailed medical record assessment looking at trigger events and a follow-up. And it was a world-class design and so forth, and found that despite all that commitment, and I mentioned North Carolina because we have a very active AHEC program, very much committed to quality working with these hospitals, there was really no significant change in the quality and safety being provided for these hospitals. To me, this is a very striking kind of thing. Now, one can always point to all sorts of good things that happened out there, but I think the bottom line is we need to go much further with respect to dealing with this kind of thing. Secondly, is the whole issue of cost. The DRGs, guidelines, and other kinds of activities are focusing on cost, yet it's out of control. There's no question about it in terms of the highest per capita cost consumption. I think Steve's going to talk a little bit more about that. And finally, the bottom line is in terms of health. And despite all the claims that we heard during healthcare reform that this is the best system in the world and so forth, when you look at any of the acceptable indicators on a worldwide basis, folks, it's, as you well know, it's a little bit embarrassing of how our country ranks to other competitive peer countries with respect to life expectancy, and evidence suggests that it's getting worse, not better. Well, I think at this point in time, and perhaps an underlying premise of our effort here over the next 2 days, is I think maybe we've run out of miracles. And as we see in this little cartoon, I think we need to be a little bit more explicit about the next step. And as Winston Churchill so nicely captured it, and I think this demonstrates all of our approach on interventions, you can always count on Americans to do the right thing after they've tried everything else. Well, I think we've just about tried everything else to really deal with quality, cost, and improvement in health. And perhaps it's time to think a little bit about how we are defining the problem. And I think this little cartoon really makes this point. This is a tricky runway. It's 50 feet long and 5,000 feet wide. Well, maybe if we approach it from a slightly different perspective, we might be a little bit more productive with respect to that. I think within that spirit, I think the opportunities are really in the intersection, and I personally have been very impressed with Don Berwick's paper, which appeared in Health Affairs several years ago, where he's talking about the triple aim, that the U.S. will not achieve high-value healthcare unless improvement initiatives, that is to say interventions, pursue a broader system of linked goals, the triple aim, looking at improving individual experience in care, improving the health of the population, and reducing the cost. Now, the reason I mention this is that he's no longer just the head of the IHI and probably one of the most charismatic, persuasive people. He's also, at the present time, the head of the CMS. And so I think we're perhaps the alignment of the moon, the stars, and so forth, we might be able to move systematically in this direction. The triple aim, however, to achieve what he is proposing really requires a little bit of rethinking of how we're doing things. And my little cartoon, obviously I like cartoons, that says, first of all, forget everything you learned in obedience school. The point being is we need to be rethinking some of these problems and how we are, in fact, going to address them. And rethinking requires us, I think, to do three things, which is sort of an underlying dynamic in the next 2 days. Number one, we need to think about the healthcare as an interactive, complex, non-recursive process. I think Jane Zapka has a very, very nice paper in which she talks about this continuum of care from early diagnosis to survivability at the end, and showing all the steps along the way and how at risk we are of missing these steps and having a continuous kind of flow as the patient flows through this. Secondly, which is major title that we're talking about here, is the fact that interventions really need to be involved at multiple levels. The federal, the state, local, provider, family, individuals, and so forth. And I have one more minute to go. And the last issue is in terms of intervention with respect to the translational process. This translational thing I think I mentioned because it's important because it's an integral part of the NCI. Ernie Hawk is sitting here, and I think Ernie chaired the TRWG, which talks about the fact that this needs to process in a very systematic sort of way, that we need to translate research, both scientific and many of the interventions we're talking about in terms of program, arising from laboratory and clinical population studies into clinical applications to improve cancer care and reduce morbidity, mortality, and incidents. I'm going to have to skip this because I've got a little note from my colleague Steve that we're running out of time. The other thing, I think from my perspective, what I see us doing here in the next 2 days in this interactive mode that Steve was talking about is, first of all, we need to determine what we know about multi-level interventions, to arrive at some consensus. Is there a core here that we can build on? Secondly, what we think we know about interventions so that we can develop some workable hypotheses. And finally, what we need to know in terms of identifying cross-cutting issues, setting an agenda for future research activity. The organizers of this have nicely presented this in terms of three segments. The conceptualization, in which we'll be talking about this morning, issues of level, issues of continuum. Secondly, the challenges and opportunities, where we're talking about the issues of synergy and timing and methodological design. And then finally, application, future directions, giving some illustrations of multi-level interventions currently in operation. This is not going to be easy. I think Machiavelli in his classic, The Prince, there's nothing more difficult to take in hand, more perilous to conduct, or more uncertain in its success than to take the lead in the introduction of a new order of things, because the innovator has for enemies all those who've done very well under the old conditions and lukewarm defenders for those who may do well under the new. I think this is something that is a real challenge for us as we approach this. The challenges we face, I think, are going to be very, very difficult in terms of conceptualization, in terms of research design, in terms of what are the appropriate levels that we need to be talking out. The risk of politicalization of some of these things, I think, have become very, very important, because as you move up to the higher, more abstract levels, they become political. We've seen this during the healthcare reform debate, where a very, very important intervention in terms of dealing with end-of-life issues became death panels, and had significant impacts in terms of what happened in terms of the legislation. And finally, the whole notion of who are the relevant stakeholders, and can we in fact communicate to each other, not only the various academic disciplines involved with this, but also communications between the research community and the practice community. And these people travel in different worlds, and we haven't had a lot of practice in making these kinds of links. Which is my last cartoon, which talks about the communications challenge if this is going to move forward. And it says, you'll have to rephrase this in another way. They have no word for fetch. Thank you very much.